Good morning to all. Myself M. Tirupati, presently working as associate professor. So now today I am going to deal with the topic is rectifiers. So this is related to the EDC subject. So now today I am going to discuss about the topic is rectifiers. So what is the meaning of the rectifier? So why we are using rectifier? So in our daily life we are using mobile phones or in homes or any industry only AC power supply is available. But in all electronic needs DC power supply. So all electronic devices are need DC power supply. So here in your home AC power supply is available. So how to convert that AC into DC? So these rectifiers and filters and voltage regulators are the main components to convert the AC into DC, alternating current into direct current. So one power supply diagram is there, regulated power supply diagram. So how to convert that one? Regulated power supply diagram. What is that regulated power supply? First case, that is transformer. Next block is rectifier. Next block is filter. Next block is voltage. So this is another name is linear mode power supply also. So how to convert your AC signal into the DC? So first initially here, now I am applying AC signal. AC, that is 230 volts, 50 Hz frequency, Indian standard. So now here first step I am using transformer. So here transformer means two types of transformers are there. Step up transformer and step down transformer. Step up transformer and step down transformer. Here I am using step down transformer. Why I am using step down transformer means I am converting the high voltage to the low voltage. So that's why here I am using step down transformer here. If you want to increase the voltage means, so here you can use the step up transformer. But here I am decreasing the voltage level. So that's why here I am using step down transformer. So here voltage level is decreased depending upon your requirement. So one formula is there. If you want turns ratio formula, N1 by N2 equal to V1 by V2. Depending upon your requirement, how much voltage is required, use that formula. So that is, I am using step down transformer. Next one is here rectifier. What is the basic definition of the rectifier? It converts AC into pulsating DC. What is the basic definition of the rectifier means? It converts AC into pulsating DC. Here, not pure DC. Actually, pure DC means, so this is nothing but a pure DC. But here, this rectifier, it converts only AC into pulsating DC only. But DC only, but that is pulsating DC only. So that is the basic definition of the rectifier. So here we are using here different types of rectifiers. What are the different types of rectifier means? Half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier. In the again full wave rectifier is again classified into two types: center tap and bridge rectifier. So different types of rectifiers are there: half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier, again that is center tap rectifier, so again bridge rectifier. So half wave rectifier. First initially here we are using half wave rectifier. What is the disadvantage? Half wave rectifier means ripple factor 1.21, more number of ripples. Efficiency is only 40.6%, means so only 40.6% of the AC input power is converted into DC. So that is the biggest disadvantage, and more number 121% ripple percentage is there. So that is the biggest disadvantage of the half wave rectifier. And transformer utilization factor also, TUF is also 0.286. Only transformer is utilized only 28%, so that is transformer is utilized. If it is utilized 100% or 90% means efficiency is increases. So that is the biggest disadvantage of the half-wave rectifier. To overcome these limitations, so next we prefer full-wave rectifier. So full-wave rectifier, so in that full-wave rectifier efficiency is increased, the ripples are reduced, the transformer utilization factor is also increased. So that are the advantages of the full-wave rectifier. So next, coming to the filter, so it is same thing. So here AC input low voltage signal if you apply to the rectifier, so you will get the, depending upon if you use half-wave rectifier means, so this is the output of the half-wave rectifier. So this is pulsating DC, not pure DC, this is pulsating DC. Now I am using full-wave rectifier here. Now for example, I am using full-wave rectifier. Full-wave rectifier means, so this is the my output of the full-wave rectifier. That is pulsating DC. So this pulsating DC, again if you apply to the filter, filter means to remove the unwanted components. What is the definition of the filter means to remove the unwanted components. So different types of filters are there: inductor filter, capacitor filter, LC filter, multiple LC filter. Multiple LC filter. So depending upon your requirement, you can use any type of filter, inductor, capacitor or LC or multiple LC. So here, this pulsating DC, again you apply to the filters means, so here ripples are reduced, unwanted components are reduced. So here you may expect the here approximately pure DC. Okay, here you may expect the approximately pure DC. So here, that's why here we are using filters. So next, why we are using regulators? Why we are using regulator? So here different types of regulators are there. Voltage regulator, Zener diode is also, it acts like a voltage regulator. Why we are using voltage regulator means, so if you want to, if anything changes, if the input changes or temperature changes, so here our main intention is to maintain the output is constant. Our main intention is output maintained constant. So that's why we are using regulator. So Zener diode is also acts like a regulator. Voltage shunt regulator is there, voltage series regulator is there. So three types of regulators are there. So to maintain output constant purpose, so here we are using regulators. So this is the how to convert the so AC into the so DC. So first step, so we are decreasing the voltage level. So next step, we are, so this voltage is converting into the pulsating DC. Next we are using filters. Filters means, so to reduce the unwanted components. So here we are getting the DC. To maintain the output stable purpose, we are using regulator. So we are using regulator. So first we will discuss half-wave rectifier. First one is half-wave rectifier. Half-wave rectifier. So first half-wave rectifier means, first to say, first what are the components is transformer, step-down transformer I am using. I am using diode. Load resistor plus minus diode. Here I am taking the output. So this is a half-wave rectifier circuit diagram. So now I am applying here 230 volts and frequency is 50 hertz Indian standard. So 230 volts and here 50 hertz frequency. So here now I am using step down transformer. I am using step down transformer. How to identify the step down transformer? Step down transformer means primary side is more turns. Primary side is more turns. In the secondary side, less turns means, so this is step down transformer. Step down transformer. Okay. If primary side is less and the secondary side is more turns means, so that is acts like a step up transformer. If you want to increase the voltage level means, so you can use step up. But here we are discussing, we are decreasing the voltage level, so we are using step down transformer. So after say step down transformer, so here I am applying the AC signal. So this AC signal. So here step down. So here voltage level is decreasing. Why? Because we are using step down transformer. So diode, what is the basic definition of the diode? What is the property of the here diode? So diode is a semiconductor device. diode is a semiconductor device. What is the internal structure of the diode means? One p-type semiconductor, one n-type semiconductor, both will combine, so that will be acts like a diode. One p-type semiconductor, one n-type semiconductor. So what is the operation of this diode means? Diode it conducts only in forward bias. Okay. In this case, it acts like a on switch. So if it is reverse bias means, so this acts like a off switch. In the reverse bias condition, it will act like a off switch, reverse bias. If it is connected in forward bias means, so depending upon if you apply the voltage, so whole sign electron, so here that will be required. So according to here, this equation will generate, so that will be acts like a on switch. In reverse bias, magnetic effects are affected to the terminal, so here equation region width is increased. So in that case, so only S power is, so approximate ideally that is 0, but in practically only microampere current is, so approximately ideally it is 0. In the reverse bias it is 0, in the forward bias it is on. So that is the diode. So here in the forward bias diode is on, it is acting like a on switch. So what is the output is here on. When a diode is on means, so what is the output is there, input is there here. This input again here flows to the. So next, coming to the reverse bias. Reverse bias means, in the reverse bias case, diode is off. Whenever diode is off means, it acts like a open circuit. It is acts like a open circuit. Open circuit means here there is no output. Again coming to the next here, again one more positive cycle means, so here the output is again, this is the output of the half wave rectifier. So what is the disadvantage of this half wave rectifier? What is the disadvantage of the half wave rectifier means? How much efficiency means? So that is only 40.6% of the AC input power is converted into DC. Efficiency of the half wave rectifier, what is the disadvantage means? Only 40.6% of the AC input power is converted into DC. So this is PDC by PAC. Whenever we calculated efficiency means PDC by PAC. So only this is the disadvantage. So ripple factor. So ripple factor means, so that is 1.21. Ripple factor means, that is 1.21. So approximately here 1.21 means more number of ripples. So ripples means unwanted components. Unwanted components are more means, so here efficiency is decreased. Again here TUF, transformer utilization factor. How much it is means? 0.286 only. In the half wave rectifier, transformer utilization factor is only 0.286. 0.286 means only 28% only this transformer is utilized. So that is also biggest disadvantage. Whenever if you utilize more than 90% means, so here efficiency will be increasing. So this is also biggest disadvantage of the half wave rectifier. So to overcome these problems, next we are using another rectifier is full wave rectifier. To overcome these limitations, if you want to increase the efficiency or to reduce the ripples, and if you want to utilize the transform utilization factor, so next we are using another rectifier is full wave rectifier. So next one is full wave. Thank you.